Yo, I just climbed out a hole that was so deep. Have you ever seen a rose grow from a concrete?
Guys, be sure to like, subscribe, share, and comment on all of my videos. Hit those buttons for me. Thank you very much. Today actually marks 1 year since I was notified that I had breast cancer. And boy, what a year it has been. It has been a heck of a year, a fast year, a very fast year. People say that time tends to go faster the older you get. And that is so true, I think. I guess when you get older, you have so much going on, time just slips and disappears from you. And I can tell you this year has been, I mean, it just flew by. Diagnosed with breast cancer on December the 15th, 2020. December the 14th, 2020 is when I actually went into my chart and read for myself that I had breast cancer. But that next day is when I had the appointment and my breast surgeon actually told me that I have breast cancer.
Sometimes I go by the 14th day because that's truly actually the day that I found out. And then sometimes I say the 15th because that's what a doctor told me. So I just go back and forth on those days. But I mean, technically it's the 14th, but 15th, I mean, whatever.
But yeah, I was diagnosed with breast cancer, and after that, everything just moved so fast. My breast surgeon referred me to an oncologist. I saw the oncologist the actual next day after seeing her. After I saw the oncologist, I went in and started getting all these different tests done, MRI, PET scan. I had to get two different biopsies done. Well, actually, I ended up having three biopsies at the end of all of it, but during that month of December, I got two biopsies, and then I had to get my port inserted to begin chemotherapy the following month. And right after New Year's, that's when I started doing chemotherapy. And I started off with the Red Devil, doxorubicin. Everybody calls it the Red Devil. And then following that, I had Taxol, and then now currently I'm on Kadcyla. I am cancer free as of August the 12th, but I have to do chemotherapy for my HER2 protein that I tested positive for breast cancer. So I have treatment a year afterwards that you have surgery. So yeah, I am still on chemotherapy, but it's targeted. My hair is starting to grow back, and I can't really say I'm 100% feeling better, because I do still have side effects from the Kadcyla, but I am very grateful to, one, be alive. You know, most women find out that they have breast cancer at late stages. I was a stage two. My cancer was moving pretty fast. My KI rating was at a 86%. The step that I had during the year when it was changing, the chemotherapies, getting all these testing done, getting lab work done, I took it literally step by step. I couldn't think of the future when it came to different procedures and things of that nature. I just really kept my mind on what I was doing at the time, and I really believe that helped me out. Because when I was first going through chemotherapy, if I started to think about surgery and started thinking about, man, I still have to do a year of treatment afterwards, and then after that I still have to do hormone suppressant therapy, I don't think that I would be in the mindset that I am today. And I don't really think that I would have been able to be in good spirits during the fight, because it's just kind of overwhelming when you think about all of what you have to go through for breast cancer. So in saying that, I will say that when I was first diagnosed, you hear about breast cancer all the time. You hear about the pink ribbon, Susan D. Komen, all of these different companies donate to breast cancer. But even though I had knowledge and education about breast cancer, wasn't in depth, so I didn't know about all of the different types of breast cancer and all of what you have to go through. You know, I really just thought that you could, at first, you could pick either if you want to do surgery or if you want to do chemotherapy, if you want to do radiation, but all of the above as a must was definitely not on my mind. I surely didn't think at first that I would have to do chemotherapy and surgery. And then on top of that, have to do hormone suppressants and all of that. Nope. Did not think about that at all. So I think if you personally don't know anybody that tells their story, or if you don't have someone that's close to you, and when I say close, I mean someone that you live with and have actually witnessed any type of cancer, but I'll just speak on breast cancer, you really just don't understand of all what it entails. And I was one of those people. I really didn't know. And you know about cancer, you hear about chemotherapy, you hear about it being, you know, poison to your body and things of that nature, but you truly don't know until you actually personally go through it or have someone that is living with you, that is actually going through it kind of with you. So in saying that, yes, it's a lot that you have to go through, but at the end of it, you're just thinking about whatever is the reason for you being here, whether it be your kids or whether it be your other family members, whatever it is that you want to do. If you have a bucket list of things just in life that you want to complete, then you can think about that. But overall, it's just, I would be lying if I didn't say it was a lot. During this entire time, I was working, and thankfully, I've always been a remote employee, but due to COVID, that's one thing that COVID did help with, was that my workload was not as heavy as it was prior to COVID, so that did help me with adjusting to going to chemotherapy while being, while working, so to say. So I was working, and I can tell you, don't let anybody tell you that chemo brain is not real. Chemo brain is real. When it got down to it, I would be so fatigued, and I did not know tired until getting on chemotherapy. You think, oh, I'm tired today. No, tired mentally, being fatigued is a whole nother ball game. I will be sitting at the computer just staring at it because my mind would just be, and I wouldn't even have anything on my mind sometimes. I'd just be like, just staring. And I'm like, oh my gosh, I gotta get it together. In my head, I'm telling myself, come on, get it together. You got this to do. So it would be projects that would normally take me about 30 minutes, maybe 20 to do, would take me literally all day, 4 or 5 hours. I have to constantly tell myself to get it together, to pull it together. So it would definitely take me a lot longer to do things. I can't think of things like right off top. Normally it takes a minute for it to come through. I'm like, okay, what's the name of that? I'll be in the middle of talking, and then all of a sudden it's simple things that I can't remember. Like I'll say, oh, she went over there to go and get the, what was it? Oh, the sales sheet. She went to go get the sales sheet. You know, and then sometimes it could be seconds. Sometimes it could be minutes. And other times it's like later in the day. Oh, yeah, that's the name of that. So that has been my biggest challenge, is dealing with chemo brain, especially when you have to do presentations and think off top of your head. And I would just be so paranoid that I would forget things because, you know, at work, everybody didn't know my situation, only a few people, and I didn't want to be judged. And that's something that I definitely have to get over. I'm still working on myself with that. Cancer has definitely opened my eyes to
characteristics about myself that I definitely need to work on, and that's one is worrying about what other people think. And so I am still in the process of working on that. There's years of thinking that way that I have to work on. So I will have to say that I am proud of myself. Proud of myself for getting through going to work. I have young kids. I have twins that are 4 years old. And I do have some times where I'm like, it's certain things that I should be doing with them. I should be teaching them. And I just don't have the willpower to do it. I don't have the mental capacity to do it, to handle it. So me taking little steps and on my best days, being able to get out there and do things that I need to do. One of the biggest challenges as well was surgery. So I did choose the deep flap surgery for reconstruction. And that recovery for that surgery was, man, that was brutal. Shout out to all the girls that get tummy tucks, because that's what you're getting with this deep flap surgery. You're getting a tummy tuck, that fat is taken out and transported into your breast, and man, the recovery on the tummy tuck, it was brutal. It was brutal, man. So that is one thing that is key, is when you're going through your surgeries, you're going through chemo, to have someone in your corner. I'm so grateful for my mom. She is the ultimate mom, ultimate caregiver. She sees things before I don't even need to ask. She just automatically knows what to do. And it has been a blessing having her in my life, being my caregiver. Oh my gosh. I would have been a mess without her. I definitely don't think that I would be as well off as I am now without her, because she has been right by my side, cheering me on through chemo and definitely being there for me and my girls, because things that I could not do, like if I couldn't take them to school, pick them up, she is making meals, she is laundry, she is doing everything. So I'm very grateful, and I hope that anyone going through this, that you do have someone by your side, your husband, your significant other, your parent, if it's a sibling, if it's a friend, if it's whoever it is, just someone that cares about you and can look after you. And I really, truly appreciate my mom. Thank you. Chemo, the worst of chemo, got through surgery. I am actually a month out of my second surgery when I got the lift and reduction. So I'm all done with surgeries, and I still have about 8 or 9 months left of chemotherapy, which I go in every 3 weeks. But other than that, I'm doing pretty good. What I have to say is, if I can give any suggestions to anyone, is it's so cliche to say it, and I hate saying cliche things, but not taking one day at a time, just taking one section off different things. Like I had, for instance, the Red Devil, I had 4 rounds of it. Just think about those 4 rounds, getting through that. Then your next stage, then the stage after that. Because with certain things, like with surgery, I thought I wanted one type of surgery, but when it came down to it, I actually didn't qualify for it. So I had to get another type. So you don't want to give your hopes up. So really, you just take it step by step. And when you have good days, take advantage of those good days. Do things that you love to do when you are in the mood to do it. Because there's been several times where I'll say, okay, I might do that next week, and I have to tell myself, no, you feel good today, you have to do it today. Because that next week, especially during treatments, you don't know if you're going to have bad days, how many bad days you're going to actually have after treatment. It might be one, it might be all week.
Heck, you might be tired the entire time. Who really knows? It depends on your body at the time.
We have to see right there. This is a perfect example, everybody. I just lost my train of thought and it's totally gone. And that is exactly chemo brain at its finest.
For anyone who is newly diagnosed, make sure that you get in a positive routine schedule right off bat. Luckily, I was a gallon water drinker a day. Maybe 3 years ago, I started doing that. And so that was a very good habit that I already had that has helped me through chemo. You definitely want to always stay hydrated. Always stay hydrated.
You want to make sure that you do start good routines, especially when it comes down to your diet and staying hydrated with water.
Things I am looking forward to. I'm looking forward to something petty that I have to say is my hair growing back. Or at least growing back enough so I can get braids. I miss braids, guys. I'm not a wig weave person. It has been hard for me getting through this. I actually might take a huge leap and try something very different soon. I'm also looking forward to traveling more.
Traveling, yes. Traveling, getting out. COVID has messed up a lot. I did get to go travel a little bit domestically. Like, I went to New Orleans, I went to Miami, but I haven't been able to do any of my Caribbean islands that I miss going to.
I am looking forward to a lot of celebrations next year. My oldest daughter will actually be graduating high school next year. I'll be finishing up all the chemo next year. My little girls will be starting kindergarten. I'll be starting a new business next year. I also have a big surprise next year. Big surprise.
A lot to look forward to for 2022. And most definitely, I just have to really, really get on the road with living life, guys. Because people say they can get second chances at life. And this is like my wake-up call to get on the ball, get things done, don't procrastinate anymore.
This has definitely been the eye-opener of to stop procrastinating and putting things off into getting things
Righty.
Done.
Thank you, guys. And I look forward to seeing you guys on the next video. Make sure you like, subscribe, share, all that good stuff. Help me get out into the YouTube universe. Have my videos rolling around there. I truly appreciate it, guys. Thank you.